Alright, looks like we got Zach Cross versus Kelman Freeman. I can personally speak for Zach Cross. I trained with him at my gym in Bozeman. Very tough guy, very dedicated training, very smooth transition, and extremely dangerous kickboxer. But, you know, and Zach, I personally know Zach has put some hurt on me in my time, but he's fighting a guy much tougher than me, Kelman Freeman from Absolute Gym. And so far, Absolute Gym has shown everyone they fought against how tough they are. So this could be a really good fight. It's just bad. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Zach trained really hard for this fight. He was very excited for this fight. One thing I know about Zach is Zach loves throwing that head kick. Zach got a little bit of height difference on Calvin, so you know, if Calvin drops his hands, that could be a bad time for Calvin. But Calvin's from Absolute Gym, and it's a really tough gym. So this should be a really fun fight to watch.
Both these guys weighing in at 205 pounds, a little larger than we've seen so far tonight.
Absolutely, these guys, they can knock guys out. They have that power is there. Let's see if they utilize it. Zach doing some good combos. Muay Thai grip and knees. Very strong kick from Cross. Zach extremely smooth with his techniques right now. Calvin's not giving in. All right, both fighters, you tend to see both fighters go really hard at first and then kind of chill out and kind of check each other out. Zach will land some solid leg kicks.
Really working those roundhouses.
Zach practices combos day and night, you know, and once you practice that much, it just comes second nature.
There's that head kick.
Very nice spin backing head kick. Calvin, though, throwing some back up his own, has that up against the fence. Let's see if he can do anything here. Fighting a guy like Zach is very difficult. Zach is very tall and very long. A good kick, though. Kelvin is tough. Kelvin ate a head kick and just walked like it was nothing.
Work
Zach working that right kick very strongly, very efficiently. Just missed with that kick. Ten more seconds left. Let's see if Cross can do anything. Time. Kelvin is tough, let me tell you. I've been head kicked by Zach, but then it hurts, and that guy acted like it was nothing. It's a little bit terrifying.
Let's see if he can keep it up through round two.
Extremely tough guy, but hey, you know, Zach did a lot of energy in that round as well. And once you put in that much energy, you know, trying to finish a guy in the second round, you might not be the same. Sometimes, you know, second round, after the first round, you get to talk to your corners and, you know, kind of like redevelop a new game plan. Like, okay, it didn't go our way this round, but hey, you have another round. Play a new round, play a different game.
That's right.
See if Calvin can, you know, pull someone up from that.
Make some adjustments and see what he can do. He took some nasty punches and kicks, but he is still looking strong.
Yeah, clearly he's ready for round two. You can see some swelling above the eye. Zach looks hungry, but Calvin's doing a very good job of keeping his hands up and not letting Zach get as many clean shots as Zach wants. All right, touching gloves, good sportsmanship, and they're off to round number two.
Calvin throwing a nice roundhouse to the leg.
Absolutely, Zach did a good job of checking that kick. Both guys, very good handlers. Not really knowing where, you know, the next strike's gonna come from. Well, moving that right out a little bit really messes with the guy because you're so focused in. Big leg kick by Zach. Zach's been working that leg all night, and this is where you start to see those leg kicks start adding up. Calvin switching stances, but he goes back.
Those leg kicks might not look like much, but they sure do get the blood running to those muscles and slow you down.
Getting a leg kick from Zach Cross is no easy task. Hey, that was just a plain slip, you know, that happens. Every guy gets sweaty. All right, they're back. Very nice front kick there. And it's really hard to fight against a guy as long as Zach is. Because, you know, you think you're safe, essentially back and out of nowhere, here comes a punch.
Definitely has a reach advantage.
But Calvin's not letting Zach have his way with him either. He is very strong, very tough guy, coming at Zach still. Calvin got a good punch there. Both parties acknowledging that it was a good punch. Now round number three. Both bodies at the very end and both very hungry. Both bodies breathing a little hard, wanting to touch gloves, show some good sportsmanship. Dave Evans referee, and they're off. Both bodies still using very good movement, very good head, very, very quick with their hands. Calvin throwing some leg kicks of his own. Both bodies, you can tell, slowed down a little bit, you know, from first to second round. Both bodies using very good technique, not being reckless, keeping very tight, very quick. And this is how you can tell the difference between a very experienced fighter. Both these fighters are very tight, not doing, making stupid mistakes, being very fluent, being very smooth. Calvin recognizes the dangerous situation and gets out of it. Very smart. Oh, low blow. Complete accident. Zach Cross acknowledges it. Calvin gets a minute or two to recover from that.
I like to see the good sportsmanship from the fighters if they accidentally.
And he knows, he's like, hey, I'm sorry. You know, they kicked at the same time, and you know, that happens, that's the thing. Yeah, you know, it's accurate sportsmanship to both part of them. You know, they're touching gloves each round, you know, fully respecting each other's, you know, capabilities. And just, it's a matter of respect. You both parties respect each other, both very tough guys, very strong guys, and they come from two very respectable gyms. So that respect is hard not to be there. Looks like Kellen's had enough time to recover, and they're back at it. Calvin throwing some hard punches at Zach. Both fighters still moving very well, keeping their hands up, throwing combos.
The fighters decided to take this one to the ground.
Well, it's a kickboxing match, so it's a stand-up for both guys. Yeah, there's no ground on this one. All right, 10 seconds left. You can do throws, you can do leg sweeps like Zach just did, but there's no following up. And that's the fight. What a great fight. Great show of respect from both competitors.
Great effort.
Absolutely. What a great fight. Calvin took some big hits there and walked through them like they were nothing. That guy is a beast.
No giving up on his part.
Everyone, just a quick reminder, Calvin is 49 years old, and this guy is sparring against guys in their prime and fighting. This guy is an animal, and this was amazing to watch. All due respect to Calvin Freeman, and what a monster.